Колорадо идет до батона.
А, ну до батона.
До батона, да.
Yeah, very important.
Но батон сразу нет.
Батон сразу.
Yeah, батон сразу, yes.
On this layout, you don't have the fields where you have to put the cards in, yeah? So it's best to push it.
Нормальный страдо, батон страдо
нет.
Батон страдо okay?
In this area.
No, no.
No button.
Huh? No?
Because anyway makes, you know, kind of little, not a little, but if Leon playing,
you see this here?
Like
yeah, you see the cross?
Yeah.
The cross?
Here, yeah. No, no,
yeah. Here, yeah. Here, behind this cross, before this cross, you have to put the cards. On the cross, just on the cross.
Okay. Just, on the just cross. Near, yeah.
And they can be.
Okay, we are ready.
We are ready.
One important thing is also if you are not on the table and you get to the blind, you have to play the blinds. Huh? Okay, can you translate maybe to
him? Когда тебя нет на столе.
You can't sit out one round.
Blinds будут ставить.
You're getting posted in.
Например, когда туалетно
идёшь.
Если на blind надо поставить.
Okay, no problem.
Против туалет.
Да.
Один break.
Два часа, потом сделаем. Пять часов будем играть.
Let's hurry up when Jesper has the blind.
Okay, спасибо.
I ain't missing my brother.
Yeah.
Sorry.
So I'm ready. He's ready.
Хорошо, что ты играешь, пусть переводить будет.
Ладно,
that's it of Leon.
You don't feel the cast because they're a new player. If he joins the first hand, after the first hand, it's also in this line. Yeah?
So that's it of Leon.
Leon
Welcome to today's Cash Kings. I'm Paul Price. On my side, Sebastian Langrock.
Hello.
Hello. Thank you for joining me.
Sure.
We're playing Pot Limit Omaha Blinds 100-100 with Straddle.
Of course with Straddle.
Of course with Straddle. Maybe you guys can tell us if we are loud enough or if the table talk is too loud. We will broadcast 5 hours today.
Yeah. Always.
Better?
Never
yeah.
Twice.
So the first hand is going to be dealt. The lineup is pretty nice. We have Jan-Peter Jachtmann, Theo Jorgensen, Leon Tsoukernik is joining us. His deck is already there. So let's see how this game works out. The last time it was pretty amazing. We had like 1.7 million on the table.
It's King's Casino. Deep, super deep, actually.
They did not start that deep today. Like the biggest stack is 20,000, but it will increase as time rushes. So there's like a little bit problems with the card overlay yet. That will be gone soon. So Sebastian, you had a nice little sleep before you came here.
Well, actually, not asleep, just chilling, just chilling. Watching my series and having a shower. The usual Monday afternoon.
The usual Monday afternoon.
Yeah.
Perfect.
I like that.
My nine high flush.
So if you have any questions, feel free to ask us in the chat box. We have it open and I zoomed in so that we can read it better.
Yes, very good.
So this camera is like a little bit out of focus.
I have misread my
name. Ah, I played with this guy, like the guy with the hat, what's his name?
I don't know. Is it Jesper?
Come on, show me the flush.
I'm not sure.
You're not sure?
I played him with him like two days ago. He played Omaha.
Okay.
I would have been first.
He was fun to play with, I can say that.
Frustrated madman, it's not possible because some players do not want their first and last name in the stream, so the guys just put the names there they got from the players. So that's why I can't tell you the last name of all the people. So
it's funny because they are the live stream, but try to be stay under the radar.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Which is a little bit paradox, but okay.
So, Jan-Peter Jachtmann, he will get problems with party poker, like not the whole batch is visible.
What's his nickname? Ah, no, he has his real name.
He is Jan Peter. No, the table is 8-max table, but Elke is not here yet, Leon is not here yet, and the guy in seat number one is having his meal, having dinner. Or
that makes sense. Elke just arrived, so it will be another 30 minutes.
Okay.
What's the delay time here?
30 minutes is the
so
delay.
So we've been at least 30 minutes, because when I get in the casino, he just arrived with Eugene Katilov. They arrived together, these guys.
So you're actually,
some
I know that
names.
That Omaha is like your preferred cash game variation. Is that true?
Yeah, actually, the last like 6 months I was playing cash game only PLO.
Wow.
Yeah. The reason for that is actually that PLO cash game deep stack is way less variance, and that's what I like.
Less variance
yes,
than
yes,
no limit hold'em cash game?
Yes, it is. That's my opinion.
But like odds-wise, that's like not what I would have guessed.
Yeah, we can go into this. Like, if you have some hands, then I can explain why.
Yeah.
The limit of pot size is one thing.
Yeah.
You cannot grow the pot too fast. Like in hold'em, you can like open raise like 5 big blinds, and then someone is calls and someone squeezes, and then you have like already like 100 big blinds in the pot pre-flop. That's not gonna happen in PLO.
Okay, so let's see.
Yeah.
Leon has aces suited once. Double suited would be much better, obvious. But do you like the call from Jan Peter? Check, check, 6-4.
Sure.
Yeah. Oi. Theo Jorgensen, pretty nice hand. Queens double suited.
You think
queen, 10-10 double suited.
Aces look nice, but you're under the gun, so you're out of position, all the whole hand, that's it actually weakens the hand a lot.
Ace queen is going to have a tough spot to hit a top pair.
Good for the aces that there's a three bet. But now the thing is, now they get it in pre. And that's what I really hate in this
in shallow
early stages.
Because it's like 100 big blinds deep with straddle,
yes.
So it's just 50
100 big blinds. That's
no, he's just flatting it. Oh no, I heard the dealer say re-raise. So in the chat box, someone says, at commentator, PLO plays way larger than No Limit Hold'em.
I know what you mean. It depends on the...
Okay, let's talk about it after the hand. So now we're getting it in because like we are kind of shallow at early stages. The player's 100 big blinds deep.
That would happen.
No, he just calls.
Yeah, he can call.
Okay. I thought he just jammed it. Because like there's nearly no flop where he can fold his hand, or...
Well, actually...
Oh, yeah.
Okay, that's...
Both flop sets. One outer for Willian, because ace-queen was folded before. And Jan-Peter Jachtmann, no, he had checks. Now it goes in, Theo Jorgensen calls.
But you see, both hands have a lot of equity,
there. That's because Theo has the flush draw going with his set.
For sure.
Like, his full house outs are pretty dead. He can only make a quad.
You
want to
do it twice?
It's just...
Actually, yeah, that's a pretty standard spot. It's shallow PLO, you have 100 big blinds. These strong hands, they go like in like almost every time.
Oh, they decided to run it twice?
That's what I'm saying. That's how you lower the
variance. So the first one goes to Mr. Theo Jorgensen. He makes the queen high flush on the river. And the second one goes to Willian. So it's a chop pot. Everybody loves a chop pot.
Nope, that's a mystery.
So because Invisible asked, my name is Paul Price and I'm joined by Sebastian Langrock today.
Hello again.
So I know that normally PLO plays bigger, but I think that's like in like, please correct me if I'm wrong, like in amateur fields where everybody just cries pot, pot, pot all the time, that's when the game gets bigger. Like, normally you don't always just like pot, 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 and then it does not play that much bigger.
You always remember the big hands, but there are so many hands in PLO where someone open raises, and there's like three callers, and then there's one c-bet and two callers, and then there's a check, check, and these pots play like, there's like 20 or 30 or 40 big blinds in the pot, not that big. Of course, there's like if there's two very strong hands, but actually I like just a really three bet because I don't want to build a big pot to don't have the chance to have a move on the river. But there are different strategies to this.
So who has an eight?
No 8.
No, maybe Dimitri.
So in these kind of spots, usually the dealer button wins the pot. If he decides on the turn to bet. So, the guy with the hat, his name is Villian?
That's Villian, yeah.
Villian, okay. Yeah, I remember the last time I was co-commentating, I needed some time to adjust to which hands are which player playing and to look at the screen, whether
Sebastian, mic, please turn...
It's better now?
Yeah, because you had it far away from
yeah,
your...
Yeah, the thing is, I had it far away because I have to zip on my beer once in a while. That's yeah.
That makes sense.
Getting in the mood. I hope it's better now.
So for everybody that is new to PLO, Sebastian, explain us quickly the differences between Pot Limit Omaha and No Limit Hold'em and kind of how it plays.
How it plays? Well, for one thing, you know, in No Limit Hold'em, the position is very important. And in PLO, it's like 10 times important.
Yeah.
That's one thing.
And one important thing, for example, is Davin does not have a flush now because in PLO you
yes.
need to use two of your hole cards and three cards from the board.
Yeah, that's
always
the main difference.
Me.
In Hold'em you can make a flush just with one card in your hole cards, but in PLO you always have to take two of your holdings and three off the board to make a hand.
Oh, it's amazing. So
now we have like a straight and a full house. That's a bet and a call. That's there's no way he's no raising. Yeah, pretty standard.
Yeah, that's a point on a paired board in Pot Limit Omaha, like with the straight. You normally like just call because like there are so many full out possibilities.
The thing
out
is,
there.
He knows he's just bluff catching.
Yeah,
and maybe the other guy has just ace 10, but this is the only hand he's beating. So there's no way he's raising because of an idea of value or something like that.
So there's the guy in seat number one I told earlier you about. He was having like his, what is it, dinner, lunch, or in poker terms, maybe it was
breakfast.
Yeah,
I would think that. I think so.
So the two empty seats are for Leon Tsoukernik and Elki Grosbelier.
Elki, yes. He looks weird without his glasses. He arrived without his glasses.
Yeah.
Just a blonde hair. It looks weird.
Oh yeah, Joseph. You can't see like the whole names of the players. Like the known players, I was like Sebastian Langrock. He's a known player as well, but
yeah.
He's not playing at the moment. So Theo Jorgensen, Jan-Peter Jachtmann. But the other guys, we go with the names they decided to give us. So it's Jesper versus Theo. So Jesper flops ace. Theo will like not lose a lot of money in that hand anymore. He has no flush draw, no straight draw. So I think the hand is over now. Oh, he has even two pair ace and nines. That's cool. It says it down there. We don't even have to watch the board that close anymore.
We can turn off our brains now.
Oh, Theo was there. Okay, Theo bet. And now it's pretty much over,
this
I guess.
This is actually a funny... it's an interesting card because now Theo might win the hand, actually. Not because he has a straight draw now.
Because he can bluff his opponent.
Yes, he has
the
position,
hand.
And if his opponent like shows weakness, now again, he knows he cannot win, and his opponent doesn't like the board at all. So now Theo for sure will be betting because
He knows he can't win it with checking.
He should be betting like 1500, and ace nine has a very tough decision.
Because it's a
maybe 1500 is too big because it smells like a bluff.
Oh, he's checking.
If he makes like 1100.
No? 1100?
A little bit more than half pot. So like, I have like a queen high flush or like a 10 high flush. 1,000, that's good. That smells very value-like. So now ace-9 is only beating a bluff, and he should let it go most of the time. It's too early. There's not so much history now.
But both of them are from Denmark.
Maybe they have a history,
yeah,
for sure.
So
yeah. Ah,
there
yeah,
he calls. One pair of sevens. Few yeah. ounces.
Well, then again, it's six-handed, so... Well, it's like an information call to get to know each other better, so... I'm not sure I like the call, but in this case it was right. But maybe this is like one hand that makes the history for a hand later. Let's see what happens with this.
Yeah. So Dimitri.
One more sentence to the hand before.
Yeah.
I think if he bets the turn and bets the river, he can win the hand.
Yeah, to check back on the
but
turn.
But he has no blockers, so I kind of understand that he's not c-betting because he has to be afraid of the flush for the.
So Villian raises that up. My PLO game is not super good, I'm honest, but I'm not sure if I like the raise.
The thing is, he's in the cutoff. If he raises there, he for sure gets the button for the whole hand.
That's what you're talking about, like that the position
yes,
in PLO
yes,
is
exactly.
like 10 times more important. And he actually flops pretty good for the hand he raised.
He's a backdoor flusher, he has an up and down straight
draw. But the same, Theo has a straight draw going with a flush draw. Yeah. Now who has the straight?
We have a flush.
Ah, the flush, yeah.
Yeah, the flush is there. 7-high flush. Not sure I'm comfortable with this. We have top two for the aggressor preflop.
There is the full house for Villian. That's why he raised preflop. Now I get it.
Yeah, you make second nuts.
Yeah.
Leon is joining the team. Tough table. Very tough table.
I guess we have the same scenario right now. The villain is value betting, and Theo might be bluff catching.
And Leo joined the game.
Let's go now.
So now the pots are getting bigger, I can promise you that.
So there's another hero call. I can understand that. There was no. Yeah.
That's good.
That's good.
Sure, it's good.
players opening range seems, yeah, the pretty loose. Straddles are possible. Like normally in Cash Kings, we see like straddles up to 1600 when the game is heating up a little bit.
I wouldn't say it's too loose because there's limp, one open raise, and call. That's very reasonable because we play post flop, so it all depends on the flop. Do you connect or don't you? So if there's just a limp and an open raise, I would like. There's like 60 or 70% of my hands. If I have position, I would call that.
It's just going to be that one time.
It's now or never.
Okay.
You know the saying in Hold'em, every hand can win. That goes for PLO too.
Yeah, so we have straddled to 400, Leon, obviously, in the game. And Jan-Peter just calls with ace-king-10.
But now we have... You see a straddle, we have a double straddle now, and Theo has like 20 bigs now, if the double
yeah.
straddle is the big blind. So he's like very short.
So Jan-Peter Jachtmann is like Leon min-raised out of the straddle to 800. And now Jan-Peter Jachtmann goes over the top, makes it 3,000 with his ace-king-10, single-suited. And Theo Jorgensen is like... fooling around and...
Well, that's an easy spot for Jan-Peter because Leon, first hand, first straddle. Of course, if everyone limps, he is raising.
Yeah.
That's why he limps and check raises, or limp raises. And he has position.
And there will be an all-in and call. Normally.
He has a blocker, that's why he feels like very comfortable to bet there with this wrap in his overpair, so There's no way Leon is calling this.
You think?
There's no way. Like 2 years ago, Leon would say, fuck it, I call everything. But nowadays, he improved this game a lot. So he can let this go. And I think this is one hand, and after this hand, he's like restacking.
Mr. JP Jackman.
It was a good flop.
What is he showing?
Okay. Wow.
Ace King 10.
If there's another ace with those cards, it's not that bad.
Yeah, Theo had a good read. Jan Peter was only showing Ace King 10, and Theo immediately announced that there was another ace. Very predictable, this German guy.
TPJ, world champion.
He will always be.
Jan-Peter fucking
Jan. That's quite, it's almost a compliment.
Misdeal because they gave cards to the MTC
to the stack, but he's not playing it yet. Yeah, understand. So, I have this question again. This guy with the cap with the yellow with the red L on it. This is the Jasper. Am I right?
No, that's
I feel slightly.
What's his name?
Jasper is the guy from Denmark, or?
The black cap is Villian.
Yeah, that's Villian.
Leon and JPJ, that's clear. Theo is clear too.
Villian, that sounds to me like villain.
Yeah, it is. Let's call him Villian. He looks like a villain.
So, Villian. Oh, Leon with kings in the straddle. I told the guys that programmed the system that they should make it that the straddle is not shown the whole cards before it's his turn. Because now we know that the straddle has kings before the action goes to him, which makes it like for us a little less exciting, I think.
Well, it's like 10 seconds, so I can live with that.
Okay, then I can live with that as well. So Davin...
I'm not giving up.
Of course not.
Theo, I'm not giving up.
Everyone knows Leon's range, so of course against Leon, everyone is opened up his range too.
Okay, Theo flops an open-ended straight draw without a flush draw, and it's a sucker straight draw. Because a king doesn't give him nuts.
Theo is out of position. He has, yes.
Oh.
But against, he wants to gamble. Yeah, he's short stacked. He's in his mind, he's... and look at the percentages.
One pair.
Yeah.
He's actually ahead.
Like, because he has every 9, every 10, every 4, every 7, every king, every 6, every 8. He has, like, shitloads of outs. He's actually ahead.
But that's the thing. Preflop, most of the hands I have, like, equal equity.
Yeah.
One has, like, 5% more than the other one.
So quiet in the chat box.
Postflop, it's
broken.
We play with Leon, he deals just once, and we have two pair.
Yeah.
Sneaky
so
two
Theo
pair.
Theo wins it. Sorry guys, I think our chat box broke down, so we did not get any messages.
Pretty looking hand you got there.
Pretty looking hand.
So as you can
there.
See, Leon does not have a straight.
Yeah, 6,000.
Yes, because
that's
he can...
You have to use two of your whole cards.
That's right.
Finally, I get it. I will join the game.
Come on.
Actually, that's my empty seat there.
Yes, now you're ready?
Like, give me one or two more hands. Explain me some stuff.
That's how he does it.
And I will have position on Theo. So it's easy game.
But this is Aki's deck, right? Aki?
It's Aki's deck, yeah.
That's fun. Leon having position on Aki and Theo.
So let's see how much the reload of Leon will be.
Should be 20.
It's like a lot of 1k chips. For you guys, the white chips are 100, the purple ones 500, and the red and yellow are 1k chips. Oh, I heard the word alternative fact. There are some Trump fans out there.
He is everywhere now, huh?
All fake news, guys.
Even on the poker table, there's a Trump.
I'm not sure. It's too quiet in the chat box. I refreshed that thing. Okay. Get all the alternative facts. So we're missing one card from
Leon. Leon is 3-betting out of position with 10-7-6-X. Is that right?
Yeah. Must be at 8 of 5. Ah! Now I get the chat box again, Joseph. Thanks. Okay. Yeah, it was broken on our side of the Twitch thingy.
The thing is, if you talk to the listeners, to the audience, it doesn't help if you use your hands to describe what you're thinking. Yeah, your body language. They can't see you right now, right?
But why did you use your body language
because
right
you
now?
Because you were talking to me.
I'm using my body language for you.
Because you have so much body.
Wow,
okay, I understand.
That's what I wanted to say. There's a lot of body to do language with. And a lot body to laugh. So, no, it's not a replay. This is live with a 30 minutes delay. So what you are seeing happens 30 minutes ago. Ah, Jan-Peter Jachtmann, 23. Just, yeah, like, did he? He started with 20. I was just switching to German.
Don't pretend to think about folding.
Yeah, it's wow. Not it's not live because we see the whole cards, but it's 30 minutes.
He actually folded the hand.
Who? Leon?
No, Jan-Peter Jachtmann. He had to bring 400 in a pot of 2Ks. Like, his hand has for sure like equity of 20%.
So that could be fun between Leon and Willem. Willem, sorry. Open man, it's straight.
Well, yeah, Leon has like nuts. He has up and down and aces.
And top pair.
And a flush draw.
Oh, yeah, the hearts.
If there's check, check, check on the flop, of course, yeah. He's betting now the river, the turn. Well, Damon is never folding there.
Damon has like a little rep with top pair. Backdoor clubs flush draw.
The thing is, William is in the middle of the two.
Yeah.
I'm not sure I like the call because he has middle two pair, which almost never improves. And then.
Well, it's internet kids here. Yeah,
all these internet kids here.
Yes, that's life.
He has a lot of equity. He knows he has an up and down draw and he has top pair. And against Leo. He's always happy to get it against Leon.
Mr. Internet.
So now we have a nice.
I love the showdown.
Showdown. Oh, okay, Leon pushes it all in.
Better than me.
One pair.
I have your pair as well.
So 20,000 in a pot. It's one pair against one pair. At the moment.
Flash draw.
Well, it's basically a flip. Although we are on the turn, it's basically a flip.
I just need a three.
Sneaky three for Leon.
I take a five.
No, I need a three.
Any five.
I need three.
Any five.
I need three.
Oh, so close.
And Darwin gets that one.
Well, there are blanks in pillow too, obviously.
I told you, Leon is always good for the game.
Well, there are different strategies to play PLO, like Leon does now, like short stack with 100 big blinds, but I'm pretty sure he's going to change his strategy soon if this doesn't work.
Well, you're not the first time. You look like
it's an honor. I'm Davin, by the way. Davin is my name.
Hi, I'm Leo.
Davin. Is this right or is this David?
No, it's Davin.
Survival of the fittest here.
Race 800.
I called it, what?
Call.
He's not playing one hand, this guy.
No.
With the head.
And it's not Chesper.
I still don't know his name. What's his name?
You're not in the WhatsApp group. Where we go, Cash King stream.
Because it's funny.
Billion, Theo, Chesper. Is it?
Sugar in the morning.
Yeah, happy birthday.
Dimitri, Smitri.
Schmidri? Okay. Because 2 days ago, he was playing like 90% of his hands. And not calling, he was always raising or three betting. So now we have another example of a hero call coming up.
I need a hero. Hello, Flocky.
Yeah. Can't resist.
Just straight.
Just a straight.
That's nuts.
Well, yeah, well, I give it to them. They're just warming up. But
yeah,
in theory, hero calling too often is not good. Also, that also counts for bluffing. But it's early. It's. Although it's high stakes, but they are pretty shallow and they all have so much money behind, so they don't care about 10k or 20, so they just want to gamble a little bit and see some showdowns.
First, I'm going to kiss you.
It's gonna change.
First, I'm going to kiss you. And then.
To kiss you for welcome.
Ah, Theo is catching some good starting hands. Double suited. Double suited is important, or?
Well, sure it helps, but if you have like something jack high double suited, jack high doesn't make you happy. You don't want to make a jack high flush and get like resistance. So, if you have an ace suited,
but it gives you a lot. It's like if you have like a little rap or something like that, the flush draw gives you enough extra equity.
If you get it in like on the flop or on the turn, then you
that's
get
what I was talking about.
Yes, but that's not like I like to play PLO that I'm relying on some equity because I get it in like that.
So it's Dimitri. It was just in our list.
Okay, Dimitri.
It was wrong.
So he just folded again. No. Look at that.
That was nice.
Do we see the hands of people who are folding?
Yeah. If he puts it in the box.
Okay, I should pay attention then.
But normally we just see it like very shortly because.
I have another question.
Yeah, you can ask me everything.
Yeah.
I'm single,
That's interesting. Do we have a hotline to the bar?
We don't have a hotline to the bar, but
I have
a WhatsApp group where Rosie is in. And Rosie should probably get us whatever
awesome.
We need. Awesome, dude.
Thanks. That might be a problem because I have special needs.
Check.
You're making nude selfies again? Come on.
1200.
I still haven't adjusted to the who is who and who is betting and who is whose turn it is.
Davin was betting.
Yeah, that is.
It says here bet and call. See?
Yeah, he has a straight blocker and he has a nut. I'm sorry, nut flush draw, and he's for sure betting again.
Pair of eights.
Because if you just get a call, he's now turning his hand into a bluff. And we should always do that, because this is a total blank. And even like a hand which is not raising on a turn should fold there.
Yanis is asking how much beer you had pre-stream. Like, I'm not drinking beer at all, so it only can.
Who's asking?
In the chat box, someone.
Someone. Aha, this is my first beer.
I was here.
The night is young.
Yeah. Later it will be chin again. Every time I meet Sebastian here, it's like, I just wanted to focus on playing poker, not drinking a lot again.
I never said that. I never said that.
Last time? Out
yeah,
there.
It was ironically. Come on.
Yeah. That night you're like, what place did you make in the tournament? I've seen you on the final table. Where we were joking around that you only have like 8 big blinds and then you ended up on the final table. During the party poker thing.
I don't remember. When was that? Like 3 weeks ago?
3 weeks ago.
Party poker?
When Boris Becker was here. Boris Becker, the German commentators are right behind us. Bobbele. I did not.
Actually, I wasn't here when Boris was here. I wasn't here.
Then it was the 8-8 thing.
That might be. Yeah, yeah. I was like, I didn't make it to day two. Yeah.
Want a hug?
No, not yet. I have to warm up my beer.
Okay, I will text Rose.
Yes, and if I have some beer in my system, then we can hug it out.
Rosie.
That's nice for Leon. Look at the flop. He has a not so nice hand actually, because
he blocks
four
himself. 4-1
suit. It's spades. Yeah, but 4-1 suit. But he flops like nuts. He's never going anywhere. And if he puts pressure on Jan Peter with just ace, with the jack kicker, and no chance to improve this hand.
You want like a normal, regular beer?
Actually, in this kind of glass and with ice. Yeah, I know. I told you, I have special needs.
With ice?
The thing is, they have new beer glasses here, and these are very thick and heavy, and they are like...
In damn glass.
They have... They're always... How to say? The beer gets so warm in these glasses, so rapidly.
So Rosie is texting back.
Oh... Look at that.
Leon rivers it.
And another hero call.
Straight is good.
He has a straight. But it's the worst river possible. There's like two rivers. That's the two jacks that make a
down Peter call.
Yes.
JPJ. That question goes clearly to Sebastian Langrock.
Does frequencies matter in PLO, for instance, when betting or calling the river? I'm not sure what you mean by frequencies. Do you mean how often someone is betting or... Yes, for sure. Like, well, if you think about it, if someone is always betting the river, doesn't matter if he's bluffing or value betting, it makes a difference to his image. What are you doing, guys?
The Germans are like making fun of you.
Of me?
Yeah, and
why?
I told them to shut the up.
I didn't listen, so I don't give a shit.
Beep. No real young guns in there.
Well, it's Monday. Yeah, what do you think? Yeah. Young Guns had a Sunday grind.
It's Sunday. Like, it's not like...
Come on.
It's not breakfast time for the Young Guns. Who has a check?
Yeah, Leon.
Well, Leon flops a little hand here, but he has no, like, real hand to play against. And as you can see, he has, like, on the flop 100%. That's, like, close to impossible in PLO, I always thought. But he did it. Now he has 100%. And, Fio is just playing with his chips.
Yeah, that's too bad. You flop like this and then, of course, what can they have?
And Dimitri is in the hand. Dimitri played a hand.
Well, actually,
whoop, whoop.
He was in the hand, yes.
Yes, Jens Knosala is commentating the German stream. I can see him. He is looking awesome today.
Hello.
He's she just came back from Miami.
Yeah, he's looked like tanned.
Yeah. Like for a really pale guy, he looks super tan. He was always in his live videos, he was always Am I already tanned? Am I already tanned? The German stream is on livestream.com/pokerroomkings, I guess.
You don't need ace to win, right?
Damn it! Now again, I missed the hand. He's on the button, this Dimitri guy, and he's folding. And I didn't see the hand. Damn it!
Of course.
I'm very surprised.
So it's Leon versus Fio versus JPJ, who is Jan Peter Jachtmann.
Ah.
Oh, Jan Peter flops the flush. But only queen high, and again, no real hand to play against.
Ah, this won't give much action. Now he's betting to see where he's at. Like, I think half pot should do it.
It's less, I think. It's 2.4. Bam!
Yeah.
I'm so good at seeing the chips.
Funny thing is, if someone would raise here now, he would probably fold, but no one has a blocker. If someone with the ace of hearts, a blank ace of hearts could do that, and he maybe fold this. Awesome. Quatsch, das ist Apfelschorle. Thank you.
So. We just got our
drinks. Yes.
Red Bull for me.
Ah, Red Bull. Yeah.
And beer for Mr. Langrock.
Yes. That's my drug.
I'm going to get you the link. There we go.
No, you cannot do that. If you give them the link, then we lose them.
Yeah,
that's
but
suicide.
Like, you know, that's customer care.
Oh. Now we have aces for Dimitri, and he's playing them. But the thing is, this is first hand and he's raising. I'm sure a lot of people are folding unless they have a hand.
JPJ is not leaving us.
But he has the thing is, Dimitri is raising the first hand, so he for sure has like aces or kings or something like that. And this hand plays very well against like such overcards.
Jan-Peter
has a good read because he knows Dimitri has aces now, not kings, because he would c-bet kings. And now he wants to... yes, and he gets him the fold. Awesome. The mistake of Dimitri, well, he has position and he has aces. He should bet at least once to know where he's at. He checked back, so he opens
to
the door.
To the world champion.
Yes, so he opens the door. Then there comes a scare card, which makes straight possible, and he lets it go. Actually, well played from Jan Peter.
True world champion.
But I'm still confused. Is this maybe his sibling, his twin brother? Because he was not folding one hand like 2 days ago. He played like 5 hours and he was spooing around, playing every hand.
I guess you played like 5-5?
We played 5-5, yes.
So maybe 5-5 is like, maybe there was no bigger game and he was like it's the same as if I would play like 10 cents.
For sure, he came
cent,
at the table
like
with 5k and he was willing to spoo away 5k like it doesn't matter. Like he didn't care. So, and now he's playing like 100-100. Maybe this is too high for him. Well,
we will find out. Maybe he needs like to.
The
get a feeling
thing
for
the is
table.
Always you have to find your limits. If you
Dimitri
play too low,
playing, maybe he wakes up now.
Yes, he has a suited ace. I always want to see a flop with a suited ace. But I want to hit a flush.
Jesper flops the flush draw with top
that.
Pair.
We have a wrap and a flush draw.
We have six, seven, eight.
This means action. We have 10k and we have 21k.
Ooh. Oh, Jan Peter has the flush draw as well. I just saw that.
That for sure goes in.
That for sure goes in.
Right now. There's no way they're not all in on this flop with this stack sizes. There you go.
Rip.
And snap. Jan Peter's hoping for a set that Jasper has. So he
but
has
like, as you can see, Jan Peter's hand would have be much better if his opponent would not have a better flush draw. So like all the flush outs are gone, but JPJ is going to put it in, I guess.
The thing is,
or what do you?
He's calling. He's calling. There's no way. His hand has at least equity. Maybe he has very good equity, but he's not folding.
But he's considering it.
Yeah, of course. He's afraid of a higher flush draw. But this is the worst case.
Yeah.
And I know him a lot that he's not always considering the worst case is the case that's happening now. But look at him. Maybe he makes has a good read. Maybe he has good instinct.
You cannot like if his opponent has top set queens.
Yeah, he should call.
What would the equity be like for JPG? It's
I had like 45%.
45, okay. Once. Yeah. Once or twice, and Jan Peter once.
I actually agree. If he knows, if he thinks he's behind, he should deal it once.
Because you most likely not suck twice.
Yes. If you deal it twice with the lower hand, you just increase a little bit your equity to split it, but you're never gonna win this pot. There you go.
Oh, set for Jan Peter Jachtmann. Bam. That one goes to JPJ.
Yes.
He turns a set and rivers a full house. PLO, such a cruel game.
Yeah.
If that happens to your online,
but
all the guys would like, it's rigged, online poker
is
rigged.
No, that's not rigged. It's just he's a bull champion. He has this hidden skills.
Yeah.
And there's no way around that.
Huh? And this is a Rolex, man.
Show off.
That's why I want to run it once. Jan Peter Jachtmann needling.
Yes. That's what you want to hear, yeah.
At least he did not say sorry. Because nobody that ever says sorry on a poker table is really sorry.
Yeah, saying sorry is actually a little bit stupid. He was, in this case, a little bit over arrogant, funny, I would say.
Oh.
To justify his just one day dealing.
Yeah. If you put your microphone away from your mouth, we don't hear you anymore. And
well,
you have such a beautiful voice.
Yes, but I'm in a pickle. I'm in a pickle here because I have to zip on my beer.
Yeah, but you did not even reach for your beer when you put away your microphone. Like, take your drink, do that.
Check.
Yeah, okay.
Back.
I'm not that pro on the mic, so I get there.
Oh, he turned a straight and rivered a full house. Thank you, Topnati. It gave him a straight as well? Yeah.
So everyone in the hand but Dimitri, okay.
Surprise, surprise! Oh. Like if you like talk about a hand history, Willem bet at 400. Hero called.
No, it's PLO. It's not high low. High low would be a very interesting to stream.
But sadly, the system is not able to do high low.
But it might be someday. But the thing is, I'm not sure if so many people are interested in high low, because that's like it's a new game. It's actually a new game.
I don't like
it. It took me like a year to really understand what's going on there.
You're on my right.
That German accent rocks. Actually, if you're talking about Paul, it's Austrian accent.
Yeah, I'm Austrian, and Sebastian is German, but he lives in Austria. So
yeah, I'm trying to avoid this accent, but I can't help myself.
Yeah, on your bike.
There he is with the glasses.
Elki.
Hello.
Dimitri limps. It's like limping, okay, again?
In pillow, for
yeah.
Sure.
Okay.
Especially if it's still that shallow, you want to see a flop, and you want to have like the opportunity to take away the pot on later streets, limping is perfectly fine.
What kind of bankroll you need for that game? 10k bankroll. One bullet!
One shot.
Must be enough! But Up and Down, it's a song by the Venga Boys.
Well, that's your world.
Mr. Langrock. I'm so happy when March is over. Prison Break restarts, fifth season after 7 years.
No.
No, you don't watch Prison Break?
I saw the first two of the third season and I skipped it because...
The third season?
Yeah.
What was in the third? Were they in the run on the
Mexico
third?
Or
on the Mexican prison?
Yeah.
Oh, it's awesome. It's not Mexican, it's...
somewhere
down
south, yeah.
No. Panama, or?
I can't remember, but... I didn't like it at all, so... There was,
really?
I moved on to other series. But maybe if you like... Hyping that, maybe I get in back. Who knows? There's always like this time of year when you have like no series at all to watch.
I watch like 20 different series.
I'm the option.
Recommend three.
Recommend three that are really good. A Homeland.
Of course. Yeah, that's easy.
Gotham.
Not seen that.
I like the Arrow and Flash.
No, that's not my thing.
I like Legends of Tomorrow. But it's all like Marvel, so
yeah,
like
I'm not a Marvel
okay.
fan at all. I need something that actually could be real somehow, you know, not superpowers or something like that.
Yeah, try Quantico. I just started Quantico. That could
not
that's like
vampire,
kind of
thing.
No, it's like kind of yeah. Homeland.
Okay.
It's like, but like Homeland is CIA and Quantico is FBI.
Mm-hmm. So back to the action.
Yeah. Oh, there's some pretty big hands crashing
and
against each other.
The funny thing
other.
Is we have the button against the small blind against the big blind, so the obviously the ranges are wider than if there's
an
early precision raise.
What a blank flop it is.
Well,
nobody has actually anything.
I didn't pay attention. Who was the three better? Who was three betting? Probably the small blind.
So is the stream broken? No. Oh. Okay. Oh yeah, it seems like we were offline shortly, but our connection was actually pretty good here. So maybe it was a Twitch issue. Okay, perfect, guys.
Works, okay. Ah! So back to the action, we have, I think it was a button raise and a small blind 3-bet and... The big blind actually flatted the 3-bet, of course, with this Broadway card. And the button flatted 2, and then there was check, check, check on the flop. And now, obviously, the aggression comes into play, and the most aggressive guy might win it. And look at this. He started with 10k, didn't play a hand, and is down to 3.6, Dimitri.
Yeah.
He melted his deck away by seeing flops and not going through with it.
And the ace's hand.
Is this hanging behind the screen?
Yeah.
But then I have to commentate on this one.
No, on this one. This one is like the Twitch screen for the chat box. And this is like, this one is ours.
Yes.
And this is like 45 seconds later. You need to watch that and commentate on that.
Okay.
But
you can say that.
The next
is gonna be sad.
No problem.
He was ready to do it, so.
Yeah.
So now it doesn't matter. Yeah, now okay. Those are the same.
Yes.
To not confuse you.
Yeah, thank
my
you.
Little honey bunny.
Yeah, I'm very bad at multitasking. There are two screens.
Multitasking
two
does not exist.
Two different time zones. I get confused.
Sebastian is the guy that won who wants to be a millionaire. That's true.
Who says that? Ah, that's a fact. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, that's a fact.
Yeah.
What was the final question?
Yes.
Who should know something about the position 20 plus 4? That was the question.
Was the right answer hooker?
No. That wasn't even one of the choices.
Give me the choices.
The choices were I get some. What was that? Something with architecture? Something with landscaping, something with a waiter was another answer, and something with
that's all you. Yeah.
The guy who gives you the driver license. What's his name? The teacher, driving teacher. Yeah, one of them was it.
So, and how did you know the answer? Why?
I was lucky. I just read this very same question like 6 or 7 days before that in a funny book, and that was very easy for me then.
Okay.
I yeah.
I sit down and I lost two bullets. Two hands, two bullets.
That's it?
Two hands, two bullets?
You're playing for three bullets.
Yeah. That's
no
it.
Matter.
That's
who would crush the table? More.
Leon.
I'm just saying, the first two hands.
Driving teacher is correct.
So driving teacher is correct.
Oh, that's
you.
How you hold the steering wheel.
Yes, exactly. The position of the hand on the
yeah,
steering wheel.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if it's called the
that
same
was,
in
that
English.
Was, that was the 1 million question.
Yes. That's me. That's you.
Yeah. Well, the thing is...
Yes.
My teacher said a quarter to three.
I was just kidding you. Yes.
it's
no, like my driving teacher told me a quarter.
Yeah, it's
a
10 to 2.
10 to 2, something like
that. Now I'm talking about the cutlery.
Everything for a good show.
Knife and fork on the plate.
Everything.
After you finished your meal, that's the position of the plate. So the waiter should know what to do.
Whatever. The elk man. Like so about
that's the wrong one. There you go. Focus, man, focus. I see. Oh, that's interesting. You see the percentages pre-flop, and there's actually a hand that's just 5%.
Yeah, but it's not accurate because we're missing one card of Jasper, so the system does not scan.
Yeah.
Yes.
Are we already post-flop? Now it makes sense.
So and now Dimitri is finally all in, and he is behind. Against that hand, he is. Because there is like every 8, every 10.
Oh, he has a rep.
Yeah, I'm just like trying to get like all the outs here.
That looks like a flip, actually.
As always. King high, queen high.
Oh, that's a blank.
He improves the 2 pair, but it doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter. Yeah, it matters if a king would have come in a river. And no help.
But move.
Bang.
Dimitri running really hard.
Jens, they want us to ban you from King's Casino. Because you destroy everything.
Easy.
Yeah. I told Jens, he will leave.
Top pair, top kicker.
And now Dimitri has a little bit of playing money again.
Well, he's back to like almost
9 or like nine, it was still in was 3, so the pot was 9 because he could have not played 3.
Well, I'm actually hoping he's waking up now.
Yeah, do it.
Because now he can in his mind he might be free rolling now. What is going on there?
I'll be right back. I need to help Jens.
Okay, I'm on my own now because the German stream has some problem with the stream or with the tech.
600,000.
Oh, we have a 4-bet? Nice.
How much?
So upper stack was a limp, then a open raise of to 400, and we have a 3-bet to 1400, and then a dealer button 3-bet with kings, which is reasonable because he has an ace, so he's blocking, and he has no flush draw to go with, so he actually doesn't really like this hand a lot post-flop, unless he hits a king. So this 4-bet in position gets a lot of hands to fold. Although he's short stacked, and Jan Peter is now obviously thinking that Theo has aces or kings. Probably he thinks he has aces. And he has a reasonable hand against that.
Is that a call?
Du weißt, ich folde nicht mehr, wenn ich das bezahle. Das ist alles richtig.
And now Devin comes in two with a similar hand. Now they're blocking each other. It's actually good news for Theo.
Yeah. I can do an ace, ace, deuce.
Well, as they say, if you have a rep against aces and you hit like at least one pair, then you have always equity to go with it. And that's why young Peter is pushing there to get this other guy out of the hand.
So I'm back as well. Oh, Theo is pretty short. He's just 2.3k.
Yeah, he started the hand with like 6-7k. He was 4-betting preflop to like 70% of his stack, so it was clearly that. But he got 2 calls preflop, and now
I was like 50k in the middle of the.
Of course, they are flipping again. Deuce would be highly appreciated. That makes sense. Yeah.
And now he needs a king and a king only.
Down to 2 outs. See, this is Jan-Peter Jachmann.
Yeah.
That's how he does it.
Hit it like it's hard.
Yeah. Like it's hard.
Knossi's stream should be online again. Knossi, are you online again? Okay, the German stream is online again. I was fixing. Now he's needling him after like sucking him twice.
Yeah. The thing is, that's what he likes. A little educating the players then. After hitting.
Water against dynamite.
Einmal so running. Yeah. Ein Leben lang.
Yeah. So, JPJ, I like to call him JPJ. There was like
sounds like a puppy.
There JPJ? Was a famous hashtag on Facebook, JPJ. When he posted the picture of his passport and the money and the new poker plot, what was his poker newspaper he owned. He posted on Facebook and then like 20 people started to crawl around. Like I put a picture up there like of 7 Euro, my passport, and the Donald Duck book, and like, yeah. But I like him. He's a super friendly guy. Like a lot of people say, he seems to be very arrogant on the table.
Well, it's a huge difference being on the table and off the table.
Yeah.
Off the table, he's very like friendly and likable. But on the table, he has this attitude. Maybe this is his game plan: to actually needle people, to provoke some mistakes.
Yeah.
JPJ.
JPJ.
Yeah, I can
JPJ
see.
JPJ sounds so gay.
I can see the many different colors there. I can see it, yes. Well,
but
gay's fine.
Yeah.
It is.
Honey?
Yeah, well, I'm still hetero, but actually, I don't mind. It's like 20 years ago when you frowned upon that, but now who gives a shit who stacks what and what?
Huh. Yeah. Maybe later we will put on our little webcam that you see how we look, me and Sebastian kissing each other.
Come on, don't give them ideas.
Okay.
Let's focus.
Yes.
Back focus.
Back to the action. So we have
villain
with a straddle, where you have a race 3x from Elky comes
Leon
in.
Leon is actually pretty like quiet in like the hands he plays today. Normally he's like involved in every hand.
Who are you talking about?
Leon.
Yeah, he's not there, Leon.
Oh, that's maybe the reason.
He's not there. So we have a straddle, an open race, a call, and a call. So then it comes a very boring flop.
True.
This is a flop an open raiser never wants to see, and it hits more the ranges of the callers. So it's very unlikely that the open raiser is going to win this hand.
Oh.
And the straddle wins, yes. The straddle has a...
Has a non-defined range.
Yes, he's a wider range, I was going to say, and he can very reasonably represent that he has some piece of
like
support.
For me as a no-limit hold'em player, like ranging people in Omaha is so hard. You know, because like I would range them to any four cards all the time and just fold.
Not necessarily. After like 2 hours, you know, if this guy is like playing 70% of his hands, like he wants to see every flop, then his range is obviously wider. But then there's other guys, like Dimitri in this case. You see his hands he was playing? He has Broadway or he has aces.
Yeah.
So his range is actually very narrow. Maybe he was drunk 2 days ago. Maybe. I'm not. I'm still confused.
Or like maybe it was like just little money for him and he wanted to blow away 5k.
But then he makes two mistakes, that he plays 5-5, which is too low for him. And then he makes a mistake.
100 about
it's too
what
high for
seems
him.
To be too high? Okay. We don't know if it's too high for him. Maybe he's like billionaire, just has a bad day or something like that.
No, not convinced.
Me neither. I'm just like trying to protect his reputation here against like people like you.
Well,
yeah.
You want me to say what I'm thinking, right?
Yeah, so. For sure. But not about me. To me, you can lie and be friendly.
I'm only lying at the poker table and in bed and at home. And no, oh, that's not true.
Elk is the only player that...
Ah, he won Sunday Million?
Jesper, not Dimitri.
Yeah.
Jesper.
Yes.
Jesper.
Ah, I didn't figure
the,
that
the
there's...
The
this
green.
Dimitri is an online kind of guy.
Yeah, he's online rag. He's supersonic pro.
Yeah.
That's a call.
Sunday Million yesterday. Yeah. I was offline too often yesterday.
We had like a... What it's called in English.
Blackout.
We had an internet and electricity blackout. Blackout. Thank God I had a couple of series downloaded illegal at home before leaving, so I could watch some stuff. This table is open for everybody to join.
It's a nice flop.
For Fio?
Yes.
He has an open-ended straight flush draw, but blocks himself.
The funny thing is, look at his equity. He has an awesome flop, but his equity is actually not that good.
He's the only flush draw against all the players. If there are folds,
yeah,
you will
see
that his equity increases.
Oh, there's another flush draw, that's the problem.
Ah, up there, JPJ.
And he's going to call for sure one time, yes. Makes sense. And we have a two pair which is calling. That's actually a blank.
No. Jan-Peter Jachtmann has now top pair.
Yeah, well, but he's not going. He was not calling to make top pair.
But it gives him some extra equity.
But he's still behind.
Against two pair and three.
Now he has position, and now it gets checked to him, so he knows no one has the ace of spades. Because the ace of spades would c-bet for sure 100% of the time, so he's very comfortable. Now having top pair, now having the best flush draw. So he bets.
Everybody can go... Can join the waiting list for the table. All you need is like at least 10k for the buy-in. Like that's an open game. So
Theo's not thinking about folding here. He's thinking about shoving or thinking about calling.
So Theo has like 10k. He calls.
And now he has like an idea that his flusher probably is not good. So he's hoping for a straight.
Blah. So this one goes to JPJ.
This one goes probably check bet call or check check. Yeah, check bet call. Check bet fold, of course. There's no way Theo is thinking about bluffing or something like that.
Oh, I just got the message that there will be a nice pot in 30 minutes.
Well, that doesn't help us at all.
So that we focus, you know? Focus.
Yeah, they should send us this message in like 25 minutes.
Well, this is the hand, focus.
This was the hand. We didn't focus. That was going to happen.
It's a German poker seeker. If you just found 10k under your pillow, come to King's Casino here in Rosvadov, join the action.
There was this question, what should be the bankroll for this game? And actually, I think...
200,
in,
300?
In my opinion, you can make the calculation. I think you should have like 50 stacks in your bankroll.
50?
50. And in this case, I wouldn't say that 10k is a stack. I would say...
20 is a stack.
20 is a stack. So it's now you can calculate 20 times 50 is 1 million. You should have like 1 million euros to play this game. This would be healthy.
I can tell you there are at least four players on the table that do not have a million or have like bakers.
I can tell you that like 90% of the players don't have the bankroll for the limits they are playing.
Yeah. Yeah, that's Elky. So, Jesper versus Devin. Both one pair hand.
I'm not a big fan of three betting out of the small blind.
Okay. Why?
Because
explain it.
Because you get always called because the other guy will always have position on you. In this case, I really don't mind it that much because he has not the hand you would think he is three betting with. So he can always represent the aces and hit with his cards he is holding, actually. But this is a... Wow. Top pair. Top two? Wow.
Top two.
The thing is, Devin is now representing the aces. After three betting, pre-flop. Now there's an ace.
But Jesper is blocking the aces?
Yeah. If you have an ace yourself, then you for sure doubt what is going on.
Oh, there comes the race! And now Devin, with just 20% equity, only the nut flush draw. And that's supposed not to come.
That's interesting.
Wait, and a fold.
After this.
That's actually not a good play. You have nut flush draw, and if you go into bet fold this is long term is very bad. You should go with it.
Okay.
Bet raise all in if someone raises you, or you should never bet it at the first place. Because you're folding away equity. So Paul is leaving us for just a second. So I'm alone with you. Yeah, 1 million bankroll, huh? I'm talking about the healthy relationship, between your bankroll and the limit you're playing. How many pillars do you have, German poker sicko? Maybe you find more pillars in your flat. So now we have the same situation again, that Dimitri is involved in a hand and he's very predictable what kind of hand he's holding there. And the thing is, he's calling, and if there's no ace or no diamond on the turn, he's giving up his hand. He picks up a gacha. The thing is, in the pot is 4,000, he has only 6 behind, Devin has 7. If goes check. So now Dimitri is checking again, and Devin knows he's not going to win. And he can always represent 6-7 or jack 10 here. And he should do. He should bet like 3k. Because he knows he cannot win the hand. He has a blocker to the straight. Actually, he has two blockers, a jack and a 7. $3,000 with the bet. And he knows Dimitri is folding a lot. And his range is quite defined. I like the bet. $3,000. There you go. He's sitting there with one pair. And hates his guts. Well, again, 2 days ago he would snap hero. But not today. He has to ask himself, what is the other guy playing? Which every draw got there. If we're honest, like every up and down draw, unless it's 10-7 and he's a 10 himself, got there, so he's not beating anything.
So I'm back as well.
And there you go, he heroes, he looked into pair, and this was a very nice two pair value bet, which looked like a bluff. Because his range is so defined, he obviously has aces. And Devin make it like look a bluff. Awesome. Well, right at the moment we have some technical problems, so I cannot see the chat. And Paul is off trying to handle it. I'm actually not sure if you can hear me right now.
Yeah, the World Cup is in Russia.
Can you meet you? Finish online?
Oh, it's not finished.
Okay, you can hear me. I hear now you can hear me.
I'm also here, guys. I'm just trying to help fixing something.
We've been we've been in a bad position since 1992.
With what?
The English national football team. It's just, it doesn't work.
Since I got my knee injury.
Yeah. We're missing Theo. He was the piece of the puzzle.
Yeah, I was the piece of the puzzle. And if it wasn't because of my
You're
knee injury,
Mini Müller Madsen.
I would have been
No Madsen? Who? Mini Müller Madsen?
So guys, sorry for the quick interruption. I was just helping that guys to get the Facebook Live back online. That's what I'm actually here for.
He was one of the top players at that time. I mean, he must be 60 now.
So, what did I miss? So Dimitri hero called and lost.
Yes, the thing is, there was a nice value bet on the river with just two pair. Although there was two straights possible because Dimitri has his narrow range and he actually found a hero call, but he was wrong.
People didn't like him too much. It was a tough time where the Hamburg had not the support of big sponsors.
So Dimitri now is all in.
He bought some players, but Hamburg was
Leon has just a 10 half flush draw. He should fold that.
Really under pressure.
One move.
So he was dismissed with some
It smells like food in here.
Yeah, because I left the door open because it's so hot in here. It's getting hot in here. You know? I did miss the hand. Like someone says, commented, it does not even know rules, says Darwin is making very bad plays.
Who said that?
It must be. Like you said, like the one, it was in the hand, I guess, where Darwin free bet out of the big blind.
Yes. I was saying, I personally don't like free betting out of the small blind at all because all the time you're out of position in the hand. And if I'm out of position, I want to play small pots. If I'm in position, I want to play big pots. That's plus EV. But if you have a different opinion on that, that's your choice.
That was so wisely.
But he doesn't think that.
Who's that?
So Leon, ace king 7 deuce.
Ah, he was talking about his play on the turn that he's bet folding equity hand. Yeah, but again, it's my opinion. If you have a hand that clearly has equity with a nut flush draw, you shouldn't bet it if you want to fold it.
So who flops the straight? Billion. Flops the straight with check 8. Like sucker straight, Leon with the second nut flush draw, JPJ one pair flush draw, so let's see what happens.
That's gonna be a nice hand. Leon with 22k, we have Jan Peter who's for sure folding now.
Yeah, JPJ.
After Leon calls with his second nuts. He has top pair and a very weak flush draw. There's no way he's continuing with this hand.
So let's see the turn. So Leon now adds a gut shot to his flush draw. If I'm,
Oh, he had a flush draw.
Yeah, but now he has adds a gut shot because a check gives him a straight. Oh, he always had the gut shot.
Yes,
I'm sorry. I was misreading the board. Sorry for that, guys.
Well, if you're focusing on like two things, it's completely natural that you get confused once in a while.
Oh, and Villian now has a flush draw going with a straight. I knew something changed.
He's betting now 4,000. He's actually pot size betting. And Leon is on the river again, out of position. This is actually a handy fold here. He doesn't have the nut flush draw, just a second nut flush draw. This is straight possible. And if there's another heart, he probably gets no more money. So that's actually a fold. There you go.
Well played by William. So I will be right back again.
He was just calling on the flop with second nut straight. And then after Leon checked, he was sure that his straight is good. And he made it as expensive as possible and got the fold. From a hand that had like 25% equity. Good fold from Leon because he had 25%, but he didn't know that maybe he had less. So it's a fold. Yes, this is real money.
You know, maybe you should join that owner circle. I know you're not a billionaire, but surely like it's in this range.
Yeah, very. I could have them, but maybe I could pay 1 month somebody. I could pay one month salary of somebody.
I think you underestimate yourself. Yeah. I see you being a 50-50 owner of this guy.
Yeah, King Rolfi, I see you still hung up on this hand. Well, the thing is, again, if you have this deck size, then you should play that. That you bet the turn and get, when if you get raised, then you can free bet and represent the aces. Now, they was like short stacks. I can see that he's betting to steal a pot. But I wouldn't do that with a nut flush draw. I would do that with a hand that has less equity. But we have different opinion on that, so be it.
Lifetime luck.
Yes.
10.
That's good.
10.
A 10.
10. That's it.
10. That's it. And it's good. What the fuck's going on?
One pair wins. Doesn't happen very often, but it happens.
Good 10.
Yeah. Best 10.
So now we have like a little update on the stacks, and Jan Peter is running pretty good. Yes, he got it in like in two flips, post flop and post turn, I guess. And he got there on the river twice.
I like Theo's answer, but I think you're right.
So he's running good. The commentary We are two, not right now. Paul is like still dealing with some difficulties with the technique. My name is Sebastian, and the other guy is Paul. We are Germans trying our best to commentate in English. So I think we had a straddle and it was limped around, so there was no opening raise preflop. And if Leon bets, there's always someone calling. But it's Dimitri. He has a very bad hand actually. But he's good right now. Leon with the flush draw and the gut shot. Leon bets very small now.
And there's the flush.
And there's a set. That's an awful river.
But like all the hands came there. Like I missed the beginning of the hand.
1,000. Yeah.
Leon is betting really small.
Because he wants a call. Yeah. I'm not sure why Dimitri is in this hand. He limped ace 8-3-3, which is not good under the gun plus one, plus two. But in this case, plus one because there was a straddle. And then pay off three times.
For the commentators, are you poker players? Sebastian, is you're full-time poker professional, or?
Well, not full-time, no. I live my life.
You live your life.
Once in a while, I play poker.
For me, I'm like I'm poker player, but not professional, and I don't play that much anymore. A little bit lost the stakers.
No. How did that happen?
I don't know. Need to talk to Hannes again.
Yeah.
Oh, he already has a visa. I called him because you told me that.
What's the reason?
For the Vietnam.
Yeah,
yeah,
right.
He got the visa.
Yeah, he got the visa. Okay. Yeah.
It's 140 euros.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, he's pale, actually.
Elke?
Yeah.
But to be honest, like he is a pale guy. But the light is not very
yes,
friendly.
That's true. That's true. So now again, we have a raise to 400. And everybody calls. Six way to the flop. So 7-6-3 rainbow. We have a bottom set for Aki. We have two blockers. For Jasper, we have a nut flush backdoor flush draw. For Jan Peter, we have top two for Dimitri. Dimitri just has 2k. He wants to get it in probably with a gut shot and top two. But he will get at least one call.
Elke with the set. Always pretty bad. Bad, it's like not very nice to flop bottom set because like
no.
So much can happen.
If you get action, then you're probably never good.
Yeah.
But in this case, he is.
Dimitri is only.
Yeah, he's very short. He's very short. Yes. He had like pot size.
Jasper. Turns the straight. All right.
Yes, Dimitri has now three pair, which is awful. David has still a wrap. No one has a flush draw. So that's interesting how the action goes on now. Jasper feels pretty comfortable because he has not just a straight, he has two fives in his hand, so
he blocks other players. Less likely
someone
straight,
has someone has like 5-8. Although it's possible, but it's less likely. So he's protecting his hand. And he's betting now like, what is this, 10,000 in a pot of 10. He bets pot size, basically. Which should get.
He has like 5k behind and he's folding here.
Yeah, he should fold there.
Yeah. So now Dimitri needs a 6 or a 7.
Or a 4.
Or 4. Yes. Sorry.
Played
the blocker and you hit it. That does
four
not
pair.
Help Dimitri, and he needs to reload.
The way he played, I don't think he's gonna reload.
I'm pretty sure he's going to reload.
Okay, he saw him sitting there like when he was outside.
No, I did not see him. I did not walk to the table.
Okay.
Just had to make a call.
A legend never did.
Okay, he sits there and he's asking for a reload. Okay, good for him.
Because the question is how long a session will go goes on today. We stream 5 hours, so we started at like 5, so it will be approximately 10 o'clock, but sometimes the players decide to play longer. And then the stream keeps going, obvious.
Close eyes and pot. Yeah,
yeah. All in and pray.
It works sometimes.
500.
The Yachtman raises to 500 on the partner. Jasper. That's definitely a hand you should defend out of the blind, or
do they have a schedule break or something?
I'm not sure. So Jasper just folded. I would have called that one. Okay. Uh-huh. Normally they do a break after 2 hours and do a redraw.
Uh-huh.
But I'm not sure if they're going to do that today.
Look at that flop, huh? Jan Peter is raising on the button with a medium hand, I would say. And he flops like
set, and what the most important thing is, he has a nut flush blocker.
So there's no way anyone can continue on this board.
How do you like that? How do you like a thousand?
And the speech play. He's up, and then he's.
Take it.
Wow, Theo is floating. That's interesting. Why is he doing that?
The stack sizes are always there to cast it. It's right underneath.
I'm not sure why he's floating with this hand and this stack.
Who? Theo?
Yes.
Must like they played a lot with each other.
To make a decision, I want to say, but already done.
It's already done.
Jan Peter.
Actually, I don't mind floating once in a while with
but
completely air, but not with this stack.
So Jan Peter Yachtman already with like 40,000 euro. Stack size?
No, it's more.
No, it just said 40,000.
It does? He had
like on the turn when he played, it said 40,000 behind.
No, he has more. If you look at his stack, he has more. He has like almost 50.
We will see.
Yeah.
So guys, because a lot of you are asking in the chat box, you see the stack size of each player under the position they're playing. Like, it's on. When the guy on the dealer button, under the little button logo, it says his stack. I don't know why we don't get like the overview a lot. So you see Theo to call, 115k behind. So he did a reload.
Yes,
reload at 10k.
Yes.
Maybe he had the 10k before and it just was not in the system. Then the float would make a little bit more sense.
No, he didn't have 10k.
Okay, so it was.
He had like 6k or something.
Okay.
Now he reloaded.
Yeah,
that's actually It's actually a good thing to reload before you bust all your chips away. Why would you play with 20 big blinds, lose them, and then get back 100? You can restack immediately. That's a nice flop for Leon, huh?
Maybe that's the hand we were talked about. We got the message early on. Is it half an hour ago? I don't know. I did not watch. But what do the opponents have? Oh, Jan-Peter Jachtmann. Oh,
yeah, yeah.
Gutshot straight flush.
And again, he has the nut flush. Not only the blocker, he has the nut flush draw, so he's not going anywhere. And Theo has middle set, but he's crushed. And the thing is, yeah, I understand this move because he's playing mostly against Jan-Peter's range, because Leon's range is so wide. So he's, and he knows Jan-Peter doesn't have the sevens because he would never call there. He was always raising the sevens.
Oh.
That's too bad for Theo.
That's a big pot here.
Yeah.
What do you think will Jan-Peter Jachtmann do? What should he do, in your opinion?
The thing is, Leon is jamming like 20k.
Yeah.
It's half of the stack of...
What? Leon is jamming 21.
Well, he has enough for strong a gutshot. He has so much equity, he should call there.
As you can see, Theo only has 6% to win the hand.
He's now calculating. He knows, I guess he knows his odds. He's thinking how often is his gut shot good? And he thinks probably a lot of times. And his nut flush of obviously is always good. So he gives himself like, I guess like 10 outs. And if he has like 10 outs or 9 outs, he always has the odds to call here. But it's a big pot.
It is.
And he has... Yes.
Yeah. He.
I hope you both have a set. Maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have not flushed your gutshot. Top set. Wow.
Bad.
Yeah, that's bad. That's right. But he was actually playing against Jan-Peter's range, not against Leon's.
Yeah.
So... I can understand the move. Well, sometimes it happens that you get it in very bad. You just has to hit the three. Just that easy.
No help on the turn for Jan-Peter. Or for you.
It blanks twice.
So 65,000 euro
pot. Now Leon the King has stacked.
Leon.
Now he has like 60k. Or even more. This is going to be fun for the table now.
Yeah. So let's see if the chat box is right and Jan-Peter Jachtmann is going to start to cry now. Like, not cry, but like...
Who's Lukas Vienna? Gutshot plus Flusher is 9 outs. Yeah, I think... Okay.
Like, he's doing that the whole, like, since minutes.
Okay.
Bashing around.
Yeah. Do I even bother to explain this? Okay, no.
Another 10.
Germans behind us are going crazy.
Because a German won, yeah, makes sense. Yeah, there he goes, Leon.
I was like surprised.
Jan-Peter Jachtmann still winning.
Well, actually, how they say, if you lose all the money you just won, that hurts even more if you just lose.
Yeah.
Casino owners wins. Rigged.
Where's Leon from originally? Is Leon Russian? No.
No, I think he's Romanian.
To be honest, I don't know it. He speaks 6 languages, so it's hard to tell.
Yeah. Gewinnbrand, yeah.
Gewinnbrand, genau.
Exactly. What's the word? There are so many German words, you don't have like the perfect English word for that. Like, what's one? Sehnsucht? Oh, it's longing. Heimweh. Yeah, Heimweh,
Homesick,
for example.
Or?
Yeah, that doesn't exist, actually.
That does not exist?
No.
Oh, okay.
Which head? Head. Yeah, this is... we call him Villain.
Villain?
Yeah. He was asking who's the guy in the hat.
Ah, yeah.
Hintergedanke? Yes.
So now Darwin adds a flush draw to his top pair. Jan Peter. Okay.
So now we can see, like, he's not making jokes anymore.
Nope.
Nope.
Got quiet.
Yes. So now we have a small plot for change, which gets checked through a lot in these cases. Oh, he's going for some value. Ah, he has a straight. I didn't see that. He has the nuts. That makes sense to bet there.
Yeah, Lucas Vienna, like you asked that question so many times and we did not answer it, and 100% for sure we will not answer it. How much we get paid?
Yeah. Well, I get my beers. That's, I'm happy.
Yeah. Good to know.
Speaking of which, I'm getting another one. I
have, okay,
to, I have to pee anyway, so
yeah,
I'll be back in
do
like
it.
3 minutes.
See you later.
Yeah.
Ask the rules before it gets on the table, you know.
Which one?
Wait, maybe.
Last second.
One big one, I'm sure he'll live.
Look, as if you hate it so much, why you're watching it? Sometimes Sebastian or me do not see, like, immediately what hand, like, which draw he hit on the river. That can make mistakes. But, yeah. You like hitting around, I see that.
Ah.
Hit the camera. Okay, fold it. Yeah, okay, there we go now. I know that, Bulgaroni. Chatbox can be cruel. Sebastian and me, we're going to cry a lot when this is over today because our feelings got hurt. Like we told you before,
yeah, yeah,
we are both not professionals, like Sebastian actually is. And I consider that, like, instead of being thankful that, like, King's Casino does that, like offering streams in German and English, sometimes being thankful is, like, maybe the better option than complaining about all and everything. But I get your point. And actually, there were other commentators meant to be here. Sebastian and me were, like, just asked half an hour before it started if we can do it, because the guy missed his flight. But so, let's try to get some coverage done here. Sebastian will be back any minute, just having a bathroom break. Yeah, and German poker sticker. Jan Peter is not talking that much anymore. But he's still not losing. Like, if Leon would have had like 40k stack and JPJ lost all of it, it would be worse, I guess. And Dimitri finally wins a pot. Can you talk about it?
Yeah. 4 hours a week or something. Are you still playing something?
Yeah, Hearthstone.
Ah, it's a card game, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Actually, I was in Katowice yesterday, you know?
Ah, there was a tournament.
Yeah, there was all the Warcraft 3 players, like Todd and Oti.
The Danish team won, right? Astralis?
Yes, Astralis won.
They're coming tomorrow again, also.
Actually, well,
maybe Oti. Be water.
Oti wants to come. You know what are them?
Jan yeah, Peter Follett, a double backdoor quartz draw. That one is new to me. I don't think that there's like one, like, I don't know three of the players. So Darwin, Jesper, somebody wrote earlier that Jesper won the Sunday Million. I don't know if it's like, if you're an online crusher, if you win the Sunday Million, or like, if you need like more results. So it seems like Darwin is online poker, like online rec. So Leon flops open a straight draw. Dimitri looks like a hitman. Okay. So Jan Peter bets his top pair on the turn. And there is the straight for Leon. He actually had more than an open straight draw. It was a little rep. And Leon has now the straight on a paired board. Yeah, he's going for value bet here. Looks like Jan Peter is raising. Wow. And a quick call. I don't think that it's super clever to bluff raise Leon, because that was obviously a bluff by Jan Peter, because Leon is like capable of calling that with a free only as well, so I did not like it.
I think in Berlin there was a League of Legends.
Oh yeah, yeah, last year. Yeah.
And it was sold.
Just Sebastian, take a quick look at the board. Oh, it was still okay, too late.
King 4, 3, 4.
No, it was like Leon river the straight on a paired board.
Yes.
And he betted 1500 on the river, and Jan Peter raised him to 4,500 with just a king high. With one pair of kings. And I was just like, I don't think that it's super clever to bluff raise Leon, because like he's capable of calling like just with a three of a kind there.
But Leon knows that that Jan Peter is not very often bluff raising there. So. Did he fold or did he call?
He called, he snapped.
Oh. Yeah, well, he has stack now.
Yeah, now he has stack. Yeah. Yeah.
He has stack now, so he feels comfortable to look him up.
I said, like, generally the race is not bad, but against Leon, I think it's not the best idea. Because, like, Leon is known, like, to not fold a lot.
Exactly. And then there's one more thing. Jan Peter lost a huge chunk of his stack, which makes him a little bit more likely to make a move now.
because he's a little bit tilt.
Yeah.
That's might be like the reason why Leon is calling snap there.
Oh, it's shaking out of his hand. You see it?
No.
It sounded like I know the voice, but I'm not sure. And I don't want to spoil anything.
Walking by the buffet makes me hungry. If you smell all this good food here...
Yeah. I'm gonna ask if we will have a break today. Ah! We have a break. In half an hour we have a 15 minutes break.
We or they?
They are having it now, so we are having it in 30 minutes. Who has green? There. Jan Peter, green. Green draw.
Green, yeah.
It's a green draw. I play four colors.
He has a very nice draw. He has a gut shot, he had nut flush. Draw.
I just saw green.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like green, you know. Private.
One second, where's the equity here?
Now equity doesn't matter anymore. Green hits
wins.
On the turn.
Green wins, but there is a two pair. No. That hand is over.
Only PLO today, yeah.
Good bluff, Jan.
Good bluff, Jan. He should show them like 8-4 in green.
Yeah. But you see, he's not in the mood anymore.
No, he's...
He's not in the mood anymore. No.
I'm like...
These times are over. You like it?
Huh?
The gray...
Yeah, yeah.
Grayish,
the George Clooney of poker.
Yeah.
Yeah, me too, Lucas. I'm like every time like I'm arguing with people about like when we play online poker that they don't use the four color deck. My only question was like, give me one reason
why not to do it.
Why not to do it?
I had the same discussion yesterday.
Like
the same discussion.
If you like multi table, like
yes.
Play like nine tables, something like that, it's so much easier. Like if your eyes rush around,
the potential for making a mistake is much higher.
Yeah.
So why would you take the chance?
So like no, it does not look nice. What?
I am used to it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know.
Now you're just getting greedy.
I also like I play on stars mostly, and I like use the whole black green cards, like not only the symbols color, like
yes.
the whole thingy. It's eight-handed, actually.
Yeah, the color of the cards has different values. You're right.
Well.
So, wait a second, what have we here now? Do we have a straddle again?
2004 players. Under the gun also. No, Dimitri is not straddling, and he's the player under the gun. So he most likely limped, and Jan-Peter raised the button. Maybe.
But
I did miss the action preflop, I'm honest.
But 7-6-4-3 of one suit is actually a hand I would fold there, in the small blind.
Yeah, plus blue diamond looks sexy as beep. Yeah. I'm a big fan of green. Like, clubs is my favorite suit.
Wait a second, we have here a gutshot, double gutshot.
And if it comes to showdown, JPJ wins that one with a pair of tens.
Oh.
Jasper checked. So what do you do here with tens? Check back, okay.
You think you don't going to win the hand anyway, but he does. I'm not thinking he's checking back because he has showdown value, he's checking back because he don't want to waste money.
Yeah.
Because if the small blind bets the turn and then checks the river, he's always in check call mode.
I don't know if the main event was.
And he's lucky in this case that his hands, his tens are good.
Come on.
What do you want? What are you going for here?
I'm going for bring back the fun JPJ.
Ah, the JPJ. The colorful JPJ.
Yeah, do like needle people and stack them.
No, wait a second. Actually, if you want that, then he should lose his deck, because then he then he's steaming, and then there will be some table talk.
I don't want him to steam. I want him like to
okay.
to needle Theo Jorgensen again. That's why I want to run it once.
Well, but Theo is not a guy who gets like angry at all if he gets needled.
No, no, no.
He's such a calm.
He survived Martin Caprell. That was like so funny. I did the German.
I didn't see that, but
it was. He slow rolled him so bad.
And he was just smiling, grinning, right?
No. Theo slow roll. So
okay.
Like, there was a bear board.
Nice.
And he was like, I have just an ace. And my, sorry. And the 10 for the full house. Mm-hmm. So it took like 1 minute to show him like his winning hand. And like,
is there a reason why he did that?
Yeah, Caprell was
we have to go just once. We have middle set, and we have a flusher and a gut shot. For Elki, and Elki is actually—he has like 2x pot behind, so this goes in right here, I would say.
So Darwin, just calling.
That's interesting. Is this right that William is betting on this flop with this hand? Seriously?
Elki folding here. Yeah, Dillian was.
Maybe these cards are mixed up.
No, they can't be mixed up.
Okay.
So now, Darwin, will not fold a lot here.
I guess his play must be now. He's checking now. And if it gets checked back and there's a blank on the river, he's jamming.
There's always a reason to slow roll Capella.
That's true. That's very true. Oh, okay, now he's betting very small. To say, I have ace-king, I have ace-king, I have ace-king. The bad thing is, the other guy has kings.
So it's very unlikely, but still possible.
It's still possible. So now he has like half pot left. Is he?
Elki would have hit his flush on the river and to straight up.
Yeah, I like the check back. Yeah, it goes check. He gives up his bluff and he's never value betting with his kings full of aces. Again here, we have the same problem. His stack is too small to play this bluff because he can bluff here, sure, but if he has a bigger stack, he can bet on a turn like half pot, and if he then has pot size left on the river, then he can
on my button.
Just go for it.
And kings puke and maybe call, but probably fold.
Afterwards, it's a redraw for the button, right?
Ah, now three.
Oh, okay. So it was quicker. So guys, we will back in like about 15 minutes. See you later.
want to mark your hand? Okay.
So guys, welcome back. We did not do a redraw. Or? No. You're sitting on the same spots as before. I was told earlier that there will be a redraw in that break, but did not happen. So, same players, same seats. Sebastian is just finishing his salad thing.
Welcome back.
Hello, Sebastian.
Hello.
Nice to have you.
I was just calculating what are the odds if they make a redraw and it's the same draw.
It's like close to impossible.
But it's possible, right?
It's possible.
The question is it less than one out on the river or is it more percentage?
Less.
Way less, right?
Yeah. Yeah, it's PLO today, guys, for everybody that just joined us. We are streaming live from King's Casino in Rotzwerdorf. So everything that you are seeing here at the moment happened 30 minutes ago because we stream with hole cards. There is like a security delay, as you can guess. Yeah, we have some well-known players, Theo Jorgensen, Elki Crosbelier, the world champion. You had to say it.
Bastian Schweinsteiger?
Yeah, Bastian Schweinsteiger, aka Jan-Peter Jachtmann is here. Another Danish well-known PLO player, Jasper in seat number one. Guy from Berlin, Davin in seat number two. Dimitri, I don't know him, the guy with the L on the head. Did not play a lot of hands so far.
If you have an L right there, it means something, right?
Yeah.
You know this sign?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not sure if this is the smartest way.
Oh, okay, his last name is Hugard. King of Denmark just wrote us that. And Leon is rejoining the game as well. Biggest winner so far. He's like more than 40,000. He's more than 40,000 profit so far. It was a big hand versus Theo Jorgensen and Jan-Peter Jachtmann, where it was like bottom set versus top set versus flush draw. Top set.
Yeah, that was
it down.
Nice. But let's go into the action here. We have a limp, I guess, and then we have a raise with kings and ace in a club flush draw.
I think you're already on the flop. I'm not 100% sure, but
No. I think Elki.
No, it's we already on the flop.
Elki has no hand, but he has a hand.
Yeah, like...
I think it's preflop, but Elki was like 4-betting.
Oh, there we have Elki's hand.
Ah, and the limper was folding. There you go.
And Jesper called it.
Yeah, that's a tough spot for Kings because... you have an ace. Aha!
Oh, and Villian is also in the hand, so now we got everything sorted out.
Now the same thing. Ooh. Now the equity changes very much to Jasper's favorite, to Villian's favorite.
Well, he has one pair gut shot.
Yes.
Yeah, I know that.
And he makes it straight.
Yeah. Nuts. Oh, Elki has the flush draw. Sorry, not nuts yet. Yeah, that one goes to Villian, and the side pot goes to Elki.
I like this card.
Well, you get this in preflop with this hand only because you showed stakes.
Yeah. It was like 6.4 the dealer just announced.
Yeah. And if you have this action like 3-bet, 4-bet, or open red 3-bet, then you feel comfortable this hand because you know most of the time these are the other two guys have high cards. Yeah. I'm still not a big fan of this shallow PLO play, but if you have like, what is it, 6K, and then there's maybe a straddle, you have like 30 big blinds.
I don't like it at all.
You're kind of handicapped, and you very much rely on the variance. Well, that's not my game, but obviously these guys like it. It's more like a gamble.
And Elki reloads another 10K. Now he's like 13K, something like that. He won a little side pot there against Jasper. I'm not sure where Renato is, Party Poker Kid. Have not seen him so far. Can
I get a I heard about him like he was playing against Leon. Like high stakes something? Wasn't it a...
It was like after the last stream ended, there was some action going on. I just saw it on Facebook. It was like 16,000, 32,000 heads up PLO.
So we have a straddle to a double straddle to 400 and a min race from Jasper with ace king double suited. I actually like to race that a little bit higher. Because you're like under the gun plus two, and if you raise that small, you for sure get calls and you're out of position. But in this case, now he has position. He actually has position, and he flops a flush draw. Top pair, top kicker, second nut flush draw. That's a very reasonable hand to see bet. In this case, I would bet like 2,000. And this goes through. And in this case again, he has a stack. If he c-bets there this size, he's always going with it. He's never folding this hand at any point in his hand.
Renato is a PLO god. Okay, we can talk about that. So the only players are actually pretty deep is Leon and Jan-Peter Jachtmann, who was like more than 100 big blinds because there's a lot of straddling, but he has 20k, so it's 200 big blinds. But as you can see, he's straddling.
Yes.
Get like the effective stack down a little bit.
But that means if you straddle with these stack sizes, that it always goes in pre or post flop, which is not actually the beauty of PLO. The beauty of PLO actually develops after turn bets and calls, and then there's action on the river pending. But they want to play high limits with 100, 100, 200. Actually, they should play bigger stacks. But then again, it's just my opinion.
The game will be there.
Not 30, no.
Well, that's a nice flop for Elke. 9 foot deuce is as dry as it gets, and he has top set.
Oh, there we go, Elke has top set. Like seven players in the end, like that's all stuff that you don't see when you play online. You know, like have you ever played like that online poker PLO cash game where like...
The thing is, cash game PLO is almost always six max.
Yeah, but like, yeah.
That's
okay.
It's a seven hand.
No, but like that like four or five people see a flop. All the time.
Online is different, yeah, right. In live cash games...
In live cash game, it's more common, yeah.
Well, as I said, actually me, I really like calling in position instead of raising with hands. That's perfectly fine for a raise. And see a flop first. So now he has... He got action, actually. I didn't pay attention. Did he just check call with his top set? Or did... Yeah, he did. Leon was betting, I guess. Can we recap the action on the flop now?
No.
No.
Leon bet, Elke called. Oh, oh no. Oh, sorry, wrong. No, too late.
Doesn't
it's
matter.
Too late.
Now he's betting, and Elke is for sure going for value now.
Which one?
He wants to get the money into the pot. And Leon has two pair.
As we know, Leon has like 0% that
there's
he
no
wins.
There's no flush draw out there,
yeah.
So he's.
I think he's
always
folding against Elke. The problem is to get action, you need to give action. Oh, he's. Oh, I just want to say.
Yeah, there you go.
Because Elke is so tight. But he calls there. I'm not sure if I like the call. Like Elke is now 3K behind.
Elke loves his butt now.
Yeah.
No, he has to pay 2023 or 3023.
He folds.
Wow. Yeah, okay.
That would have been the like most sick bluff ever.
Yeah, there's only one hand he's beating, which is like 8, 9, 10 jack. And this hand got there, so... No, actually 8, 9 was good anyway.
Yeah, so. 8, 9 would have been good, two pair.
So this was... Maybe he's just calling to say, if I bet and you raise me, I call you anyway, so stop bluffing me.
Yeah.
Maybe that's the message for the table. Who gives about 8k, huh? Who gives a hoot?
Like the last 100-100 game, everybody bought in for like a 50 or 100,000, which was like way deeper and like with so much more action, obvious.
Why was that? Why was this deeper?
Because like there was some trick, Sam Trickett, Rob Young,
yes,
all those guys were playing, and they just decided like the minimum buy-in I think was 30.
Well, I can get behind this idea because they want to play PLO deep stack cash game. Because they see their edge there.
So Jesper opened, Devin free bets, Leon calls with single suited ace.
That's a perfectly good call and on the button with this hand for sure.
So let's see if Jesper is like, I think he's just flatting or?
Yeah, he's calling almost always there because. Again, it's the same spot. He has small cards and hoping the other guy have big cards. And if he connects...
So two pair for Devin would be good flop for... Yeah. So Devin's aces do not matter anymore because now he has trip eights.
Yeah, good for him. He's going to see bad and gets two very quick folds. Ah, he's trapping Leon. Uh-huh. I'm not actually a fan of trapping Leon because Leon is, if he has something, he's calling anyway.
The audio is a little weird. What do you mean with weird, guys? Just explain it, maybe I can fix it.
Maybe the things we're saying. The aces matter again, look at that. Delayed c-bet, but it's not going to change the outcome of the hand. He's wrapping exactly the hand he's having, so
we got robot boys.
There's no way anyone gets an idea. Or there's a hero call because he thinks he has ace high. Check.